Thank you. All right, good morning.
Good morning.
I'd like to welcome you to worship this morning. You see, it's Family Worship Sunday. Instead of being on the farm, we are on a scavenger hunt, a Bible scavenger hunt. Including a skit and one of some games. In the way of announcements, there is a UMW meeting immediately following worship today to talk about the soup and the yard sale. And this today after worship. On Wednesday, we have Bible studies at Fairton UMC. It's at noon if you want to come attend. This Saturday is our soup and yard sale at 9 to 1. There's lots of yummy soup that'll be there and goodies. So come and support your church. A family night dinner at Fairton. The next one is November 12th. That's, of course, a Tuesday at 6 p.m. And since it's around Thanksgiving, we're doing turkey as a main dish. And the next Basher Cluster Hymn Sing will be here. So if you like singing your favorite hymns, this is your chance. November 17th at 6 p.m. Is there any other announcements that should be made? Well, let's go to God in prayer this morning. God, I confess I rarely take time to be in awe of how you chose to create mankind. You made us in your image after your likeness. In Hebrew, the words used to describe a representative of the King. So Lord, may we live and breathe the breath you breathed into us. May we seek in every moment of our days to represent you. Day by day, moment by moment, may we show the world your glory. In your transforming name, amen. Please stand if you're willing and able for the first hymn, number 145, Morning Has Broken. Apostles' Creed, it's 881 in the hymnal. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Skit. We're in a new theme, the Bible scavenger hunt. We have Laura and Brandon. Lauren is me. I'm the scripture scout. We're looking for scripture, and Brandon is my scout leader, scripture scout leader. And we're going to walk out in the woods trying to find our way home.
Watch the sticks.
Watch the sticks, she says. Okay. Nature hike. This is going to be great. Thank you so much for being an awesome leader, Brandon.
No, you're awesome.
No, you're awesome.
Okay, we're both awesome. Let's do our secret handshake.
Got it down, Brandon. We're going to get lost. I'm not so good at this. Sometimes I feel completely useless. I don't want to do this anymore. What does getting lost in the woods have to do with the Bible anyway? I want my Nintendo Switch.
I'm sorry you're not having a good time. I think you might just be hungry and thirsty. Why don't we take a break and you grab something to eat and drink from your backpack?
Okay, that sounds good.
Right. reflection of your face. But it's not you. It looks a little like you, but it's not you. It's a representation of what you look like. It's an impression of who you are. That's what it means to be made in the image of God. We all look like ourselves, but we resemble or look like God. When we honor God, we leave a good impression of God.
Okay, well, why should that cheer me up?
Don't you see, Laura? God only made you, but he made you in his image. He loves you and wants you to have a relationship with you.
I guess that's pretty cool.
It sure is. Knowing that I'm made in his image makes me more confident. It makes me feel good about myself.
It makes me feel good too.
Being made in God's image does come with responsibility, though.
What do you mean?
I mean that if we represent God, we need to treat people the same way that God would treat them.
Sometimes that's really hard. Sometimes people aren't nice, but I still have to be nice back.
Yep, you got it, bud.
You still didn't answer my other question.
What was that?
What getting lost in the woods has to do with the Bible?
I think if we do some more hiking, you might find out that one out on your own.
The end. Thank you, Mr. Dan. I want to come on there. This is up. Put my own foil up because that goes in my kitchen. You love ya. I'll leave it here. Come on down. All right, we're doing a Bible scavenger hunt. So today, I'm going to give you 5 minutes. 5 minutes to figure it out, okay? That's going to be part of the solution, too. Okay, let me see. Well, when I usually read scripture for Sunday, do you guys know where I read scripture from? Or is that?
The Bible.
The Bible. And where do I usually read it from? Up there, right? So does somebody want to go up there and see what the Bible that I've laid out says? Well, you got somebody on top of you. Okay, go ahead.
Well, we could all go.
You get it. You can go with her if you want.
I'm going with her too.
As well. Go up there and see what it says. What? Look at the Bible it says.
It says Genesis.
Genesis. Okay, so the scripture is Genesis. Okay, can you come on back down here? Yeah, walk so they don't give everybody a stroke. We don't run in church. Some kids, the last one said, can we run? No, we can gallop maybe. I don't know. We used to skip in school. I ain't skipped since kindergarten. I don't know what they taught us that for. Coordination, I guess. Okay, there's two signs. I already gave it away. There's some signs that are around here. Let's say Bible scavenger. How many are there?
Two.
Really? Did you? Where are they at?
The window is right
one there, and there's one there. Okay. How many minutes did I tell you had to do?
Five.
So it's what was this Bible?
Genesis.
Genesis
2.
2:5, but then it's 2:25. So it's easy the first time. It'll probably get harder next time. We're talking about today about being made in God's image. And we are going to reflect the image of each other in the same way we reflect the image of God. So we're playing this game called Mirror, Mirror. And I think we're going to have one student be the leader. That worked out better at the other church. You are the leader, and we're going to face the leader, and you position your body however you want us to mimic it. And no running through the church, because glory don't run anyway. So you might put your hand on your head, on your belly, and then change every so often. If I yell change, you got to change it. You want to be leader first? All right, so we got to step up, stand up. And we'll get this over here so they can see everybody, or somebody anyway. I'm out of the picture, thank goodness. All right, so we're going to follow you as the leader. We got to follow what she does. She's getting harder, but she did spin around, didn't she? She only did it once, though. She's still walking. Oh, boy.
You better hope she doesn't do a marble.
Yeah. Peace out. What is going to walk out the door? Well, that's all right. She's going to turn aside around. Do you want to, now we're going to switch. You can do it. You, it's your turn this time. Now mirror her. Whoa, I'm not falling. I'm not falling. Now mirror y'all. Well, I'll keep my steps in the day. Which might work in the dark.
They need flashlights.
Day.
They need flashlights.
Yes, I have to give them their flashlights. Let me get that while I'm thinking of it. Do you want pink, orange, or green?
Pink.
Oh, I only got one pink.
She can have the pink.
Okay, which one do you want then? Orange. We have a yellow one too. I forgot about that. Orange or pink? Okay. You can go sit up over there. We're done with the food. We're done with the games. Okay. Remember the camera. Oh, okay. You can see the rest of my head now. There we go. Okay. Now's a chance to share your joys and concerns. I did get one from Karen, of course, now I can't read my own writing. Karen Wolber, I believe it is, was diagnosed with esophageal cancer. I can't even say that word. Karen has esophageal cancer. Esophagus.
Esophageal.
It doesn't look like that when you're trying to read it. I have to write my own thing. You love my spellings. I put my own phonetic spelling behind it. Esophageal cancer. Okay. What else should we be praying or thanking God for? Yes?
I have a friend named Finn. His name really is Indy Finn.
Finn.
My wife's name is Crystal. She had esophageal cancer. 4 years ago. Well, I came back when they were on a trip this year. They were in Italy.
Okay.
And, you know, she thought she was in remission and didn't have any problems. Well, they flew her back with a private jet.
Oh, really?
To the Mercies, you know?
Right.
And they took her to John's office. And she just underwent a total of 12 hours of surgery.
Wow.
They tried to save her arms, and they couldn't. So we need to pray for her because she's really deeply depressed.
Okay.
She can't go.
What's your first name again?
Crystal.
Finn. Crystal Finn. Is having depression after having. Right. Okay.
And she's only in her 50s.
Wow. Okay. So she can't talk, and they had to take a, you know, all the cancer out. Right. Right. After, yeah. Yeah. But pray for Crystal because she's depressed. I'm sure if you weren't able to speak, your spouse might be a little happy about it, but you wouldn't be too happy. Yeah. So be in prayer for Crystal. Yes.
I made out well with my pet kid.
Amen.
There hadn't gone any place else. My blood work was very good. And I just take it one day at a time. And thank you for your prayers.
Amen. So glad that she got positive results from our pet scan. We definitely need to pray for rain. I keep looking outside to see if I'm going to see the deck be wet, and it's only got dew on it every morning. Our lawns are crunchy, and there's so many fires. You'll hear the brush fire here, brush fire there. As soon as it lights up, it goes. So we also pray for our firefighters because they're going on a lot of calls. At least that's what Kevin Scarletto said. So be in prayer for them as well. Yes.
And this week I went there and take a picture of my bladder, take a biopsy.
Okay. Picture and a biopsy? Okay. Biopsy. So be in prayer for Ed as he has his biopsy. Yes.
My name is Dot.
Dot?
Yes. Of course, Lisa, Kay, Rachel, Cobb, they all had COVID.
Ah. So Dot and her daughters have COVID. Okay, be in prayer for them. Anything else? Want to praise God for or pray for? Yes.
Friday, my, believe it or not, oldest grandchild turned 16.
Wow.
My daughter is like, oh my God, I can't believe he's going to be driving soon.
Right.
I don't, she had, and the funny part is, she's got four kids, but she's like, I really don't want him when he's 18 to leave or anything. I'm going to stay. Because he's like a really sweetheart. He's always been a sweetheart since he was little. Very kind hearted. But it's just so weird to say 16.
Right. Yeah, you keep feeding them, they keep growing, you know. So I tell people.
Yeah.
But then you turn around and they're grown. Yeah, no time. Okay, anything else? What are you praying about? All right, well, let's go to God in prayer this morning. Lord, we are grateful to come in the house of God today. We want to lift up those we regularly remember: Ed and Shirley, Ruth McGarvey, Ruth Lupton, Mary Lou, Mary Bell and Sharon, Weeves, Sister Mary, and Judy. We're grateful that Mary Lou got positive news that there's no new growth. And we're grateful that you have just given her your encouragement. And I pray continue just to have positive test results. We lift up Ed, who is having a biopsy this week. I pray for your, for you to be with him and keep him at peace, because waiting for results is painful sometimes. So be with him and be with the doctors. They do well by him, and if we can figure out what to do next. We want to lift up Dot and their daughters who have COVID, and I pray that you, it would be a mild case, that they would get back on the mend soon. And I pray that no one else gets sick from it. Lift up Karen Wolver, who had just been diagnosed with esophageal cancer. We ask that you would be with her, and she's just the beginning of her journey, that you would help her to be able to sustain her for whatever lies ahead. We also lift up Crystal Finn, who also had this same cancer, but had to have her surgery, and now is depressed. And I pray that you would give her the strength to go on, be with those around her to encourage her, and be with all those that help take care of her, that they would have extra grace. And we also ask for some rain. It's been so long since we've had any rain, and I pray you would help us to be mindful of when we have fires or any kind of thing that could set a fire, that we would not make any more work for the firefighters to do. But I lift our firefighters up to you as they're going on all these extra brush fire calls and different things, that you would just help them to have the stamina. And I pray that we would be more mindful of what we're doing. Be with Mary Bell and Sharon as they are still visiting with family. I'm grateful that Mary Bell got good news and that she just needs to move around a little more, but the doctor's happy with her progress, and so we're grateful for that. Get them home back safe to us when they do come back. And hear us now as we pray the prayer you taught your disciples. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now it's time for our second hymn. It is number 420, Breathe on Me, Breath of God. Please stand if you're willing and able and sing with me. Trying to get across today is God made us in his image. One of my favorite kids' books is called Joseph Had a Little Overcoat. I don't know if you've ever heard of it, but it's about a man who had a coat, but it got worn out. It wore out, but he kept recycling it and repurposing it until there was nothing but a button. Nothing but a button left. And then he lost that. But that's not the end of the story. After he loses it, he writes a whole story about it. And the moral of the story is that you can make something out of nothing. And God is the very best at doing that. He created the universe just by speaking, and it made man by breathing life into dust. Let's read from Genesis 2, verses 5 through 25. It shouldn't be too hard to find. Genesis 2, where's that? 5 through 25. This is the second creation account. There's one in for chapter 1, of course. So 5. There were no plants or grain growing on the earth, for the Lord God had not sent any rain. That sounds familiar. And no one was there to cultivate the soil. But water came up out of the ground and watered all the land. And the Lord formed God formed a man's body from the dust of the ground and breathed into it the breath of life. And the man became a living person. Then God planted a garden in Eden, in the east. And there he placed the man he had created. And the Lord God planted all sorts of trees in the garden, beautiful trees that produce delicious fruit. At the center of the garden, he placed the tree of life and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. A river flowed from the land of Eden, watering the garden and then dividing to four branches. One of these branches is Pishon, which flows around the entire land of Havilah, where gold is found. Gotta love these names, right? The gold of that land is exceptionally pure. Aromatic resin and onyx stone are also found there. The second branch is the Gihon, which flows around the entire land of Cush. And the third branch is the Tigris, which flows from the east of Assur. The fourth branch is the Euphrates. Some of them sound familiar, right? The Lord God placed the man in the Garden of Eden to tend and care for it. But the Lord God gave him this warning: you may freely eat of any fruit of the garden except fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. If you eat this fruit, you will surely die. And the Lord God said, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make a companion who will help him. So the Lord God formed from the soil every kind of animal and bird, and he brought them to Adam to see what he would call them. And Adam chose a name for all the animals, for each one. He gave names to all the livestock and the birds and the wild animals. But still, there was no companion suitable for him. So the critters weren't enough for him. Might have been enough for me, I don't know. Just joking. So the Lord God caused Adam to fall into a deep sleep. He took one of Adam's ribs, closed up the place once he had taken it. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib and brought her to Adam. At last, Adam exclaimed, she is part of my flesh and bone. She will be called woman because she was taken out of a man. And this explains why a man leaves his father and mother and joined to his wife, and the two are united as one. Now, although Adam and his wife were both naked, neither of them felt any shame. God made man out of the dust. You imagine that? God made man out of dust. If you've been in church a while, you've heard this story, and it might not seem that exciting to you, but think of it this way. Can you scoop up some dust from under your couch? Or actually go up to that ceiling fan you know needs cleaning, scrape that stuff off of there, and turn it into a living, breathing human being? I know I can't. I ain't that good. I got enough dust to build a few people, an army of people probably, but it doesn't happen. And God didn't just create man and woman. He created us in his image. In his image. He created us to create and to love, and to have a relationship with him. God put man in absolute paradise, giving him everything he could ever need. He had fruit from the trees. He had animals. and he had a job. He had to take care of the land, tend to his work. What else could he have needed? But the Bible said it wasn't good for this man to be alone in the garden because his world wasn't complete yet. He needed someone to share his love with and reflect God's love toward. Because we're made in God's image, we can shine his light wherever we go. So being made in the image of God can mean a lot of things. For some of us, it's learning how to be comfortable in our own bodies that God gave us. Maybe harder for some of us. And it can also mean taking care of our bodies by eating healthy foods, getting good exercise. But it also means resting and getting enough sleep that some people don't seem to always do. Being made in the image of God can also be meaning to learn to live in a way that looks like God. If God is love, how can I be more loving? If God is kind, how can I be more kind? If God is forgiving, can I be more forgiving? So let's end with the question. How can you live differently because you know that you're made in the image of God? So think of that this week. How can you live differently because I know that I am made in the image of God? Let's pray. Dear God, help me to reflect you and your love in all that I say and do. In your name we pray. Amen. Now we continue to worship the Lord by presenting our tithes and our offerings. Grateful to give back to our church, so we ask that this blessing be a blessing, that it be used for your to honor you, and that would be good for our community. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. So does anybody have a testimony to give or a song they'd like to sing? Right.
But everywhere you look, it's just, God does a good job.
Right.
And it's just tree and tree.
Right.
So I thank you for that.
Yeah, it's definitely a beautiful time of the year. Like I said, if you don't have to rake them, they're beautiful. We don't have to rake them. As Danny said, when we moved and made this house, there's no trees in the yard. We've got woods around us, so we can see all the trees. And I thought, well, that's kind of crappy. I want to sit under a tree, you know, with some shade. But now that I see why, he doesn't have to go around and do anything with the mower, and the leaves come down, I just watch them blow away. And I say, ha, neighbors, good luck with that, because everybody has trees everywhere.
They don't get in your gutter.
Yeah, don't have to deal with gutter guards, even though we didn't have good gutters.
But leaves, no sticks.
So, if I want to climb a tree, I have plenty of trees. I can go get an inkling and just up a tree. That's not going to happen, but I go right in the woods if I need to do that. So. Yeah. Anybody have a favorite song they'd like to sing? Four, one, nine. Yeah. 419. I am mine, O Lord. Okay. Little Fanny Crosby song. Sing first and last. Hymn survey, I keep looking. Oh, that, see who the authors are. Definitely well known hymn writer. Anybody else have a favorite song or a testimony?
419.
419, we just did.
We did?
I am not.
I have a different book.
Oh, it's okay. Is it in the other book, you know?
No.
Oh, okay.
Sure.
Okay, does anybody else have a favorite? Ah, yeah, we could do that one.
Yep.
I think it's 657, but I could be
right
wrong. Yep. 657, this is the day. We'll sing it through twice. 657. You know the words anyway, so you don't probably need them, but she needs the music. 657.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it.
church to discuss the soup and to sail. I think that's it. Now receive a benediction. So go from here and live that life. Live that this is the day the Lord has made. And that you are made in the image of God. And don't forget that. And live accordingly. Go in grace and peace. Amen. Yeah.